34th edition in Jaipur of Tech Sabha is, you know, going full swing. We have a lot of government leaders as well as technology solution providers here with us in Tech Sabha. Joining me is Mr. Gurinder Singh. He's a manager solution engineering, Indian SAARC from Netskope. So he's going to tell us like what he really liked about being in Technology Sabha and what he really covered in his session. So let's hear from Mr. Singh. So hello, sir.
Hi. Hello. Thanks so much for inviting me for this soundbite. So I would say like the experience so far has been pretty, so it's the second day for Tech Sabha, right. And the experience so far has been excellent and awesome, I would say. And I was really excited to meet a lot of government delegates and the kind of presentations which has happened, wherein we are seeing how government is basically leading the digital transformation today. Right. And there are a lot of projects which are there where a lot of vendors, especially on the security and cloud security side, which can really value add to the digital transformation journey for the government. That is something which I really loved about the context here. Yeah.
Right. This is specific to the, since Sabha is all about e-governance and digital governance, so what essentially you covered in your session and what has been, you know, a key thing which you really think gonna make a lot of impact in the government sector?
Okay, actually, like if we talk about Netskope, so we are into cloud security solution provider, and like we have taken a lot of digital transformation journey for enterprise segment in India as well as across the globe. We have been leaders in the Gartner quadrant, but I would say like with respect to whatever I heard from the delegates on the government side, we can do a lot of value add. In fact, we have started interacting with a lot of government bodies and we have started positioning our solution, and our solution is majorly about how the government can take the digital transformation journey, right, with vendors like us, where we can add with respect to zero trust framework for them, mm-hmm, we can add with respect to data leakage protection, and we can add with respect to secure service edge space framework, which is coming in and quoted by Gartner holistically.
Right.
So in that case, if I see a lot of nationwide attacks which are happening on the government bodies, we can have one level of protection from our solution, specifically on the threat protection side, ransomware protection, data leakage side, and that is the areas where we have a forte.
Right.
And with a lot of ML AI scanning engines which are built in our cloud to provide this holistic security.
Okay,
yeah.
Right. So sir, any major learning from here, you know, which you really gathered and you really want to go back and let, you know, understand this whole thing, the conversation which you made with a lot of delegates, so what really one thing which you really, you know, want to work around when you go back?
I can only say like the scale for government is pretty heavy, and a lot of these vendors have to really partner in order to provide a holistic security solution for the government enterprises. So it's not a piecemeal solution where, mm-hmm, a specific solution can really value add. So there has to be a lot of platform-centric approach. There has to be a lot of interface between different vendors, especially to provide or to devise the digital transformation journey for the government. And I think so, government is really placed right, wherein we have a lot of youth force today, where they can utilize and they can really value add to the digital transformation journey which government can take today. A lot of investment coming in from government in the cybersecurity space, in the cloud space,
right,
which I really was really interested in and lucky to hear about it.
Right.
Yeah.
Great, thank you so much, and I wish you all the
thank
best
you so
for
much.
Your
Thanks,
further opportunities. Yeah, thank you.